Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mayur Mahajan once again in front of you. Now this time the idea is something very different. We need to take a video of a discussion how we HHFians understand the remedy, and I am very much privileged to find this youth icon of HHF Dr. Joeyin in front of me with all of you, of course, and we will be discussing Ignitia. So the Ignitia remedy will be discussed today. My dear friends, this is the most commonly found, the what we call as a bread and butter remedy of our homeopathy clinics. And, right? And see, you may be find me with a very new lookout with the specs, but yes, it brings a very serious, earnest effort. That I am a very serious guy here standing in front of you, because the remedy is really very serious. So accordingly to the remedies, my outlook will be something different. So the Ignitia patient, Joeyin, we remember na ke this Ignitia in our LLS keynote we find a rubric contradictory symptoms. What do you mean by contradictory symptoms of the physical symptoms I'm talking about, right? Guys, this is the physical symptoms of Ignitia. And the main keynote is contradictory. What is this contradictory all about?
We were waiting in the clinics to find those contradictory symptoms to come to us and then prescribe. So some of the examples in those keynotes are
means contradictory, means the normal of layman also will find it odd, or exactly. The but obvious amelioration will be aggravation,
right?
This is contradictory. Still I would like to tell you, focus upon this is really very important to understand, because if you understand this contradictory of Ignitia, you'll understand Ignitia, because we will correlate this contradictory
with the mentals.
That is very very interesting. Now imagine I'm suffering from throat pain and I'm better with cold water. But obvious contradictory statement. How? Isn't it very interesting, guys? Now, Joeyin will tell us something about this contradictory. The first rubric, let us, Joeyin, can you please elaborate on this contradictory of this emotional makeup of Ignitia? What is this contradictory nature all about?
The rubric that could relate to this physical characteristic would be imbecility negativism.
Very good. Note it down. Imbecility negativism. Okay, note it down. Yes.
So with a short case, maybe it would be better to
very
understand.
Good. So very good.
I had a small patient, a little child, 10 to 11 years old, and a very bubbly, very good, a goody child.
Achha.
Never any complaints with the family.
Note it down, please, Joeyin. Yeah. Note it down. A very bubbly, a very vivacious, a very playful child. Okay.
And there were never any complaints about him in the family. He was a good
never
child.
Ever any complaint. Used to, a very obedient, you mean to
right,
say.
Right, exactly.
A very obedient
very
child.
Very obedient child.
Not
and then they have their second baby. And he's very excited about the second baby. He loves the second baby.
Hello. Again, take a pause. The second child comes in the family. Okay? The second child is now again in the family. But at the same time, this Ignitia child is very caring with this child.
Right.
Very caring.
Very caring. Very loving.
Very loving. That is very important.
He takes good care of the kid. He is very affectionate towards it. But then, slowly and surely, he starts feeling that all the love and affection and care is being diverted to that child, and I am not getting any.
Oh my God! So how will the child feel? Yeah, come on. Right. How will the child feel? She'll feel bad. Yeah. Shit. Is it?
Yes.
Okay. Then.
And then slowly his behavior, he became very, low, dull. He used to keep to himself, that bubbliness reduced. And slowly he became, that graph came down.
The bubbliness, the playfulness, the vivacity, the charm, the affection, the care goes day by day down. Okay?
Right. And then after a certain point, the mother says, since the last year, he's become very defiant, he's very disobedient.
Again, the child has become very defiant, very disobedient.
And
first he was very obedient, now disobedient. see the contradictory feelings.
And then, what do you say? The mother, usually you get this in the history, they said, ye aisa nahi tha. He was not like this.
Note it down, Doctor sahab, mera beta aisa nahi tha. This was not my child. This is very important.
Right.
This was not my child. Ye aisa kaisa ho gaya?
Obedient becomes the disobedient.
Okay? The one who used to be so loving, so caring, and that warmth, instead of this warmth, what happens is the chilliness comes up. What is this chilli? If you find ignition physical symptoms, thermals, it is found that in acutes it is hot and in chronic cases it becomes chilly. What does it mean? Ignition has both the states of thermals. Ignition is hot as well as chilly. If you find in orthodox books, you'll find. Why? What is this warmth? What is this warmth? In the initial state. In the initial state of a disease. See, in his case, when the child was alone, the single child, everyone was looking, giving that due attention to this only child of the family. So, at that time he was very loving, caring, warmth. Very warm. Warm-blooded. Means what? This is cozy, yeah. How are you, man?
Yeah.
This is warm. And this is chilly. This is chilly. Now, Ignisha become the one who was the... Hi Kaka, hi Uncle, hi Mama. Was very warm. Now this is chilly. Now this chilliness you need to understand with the help of the emotional quotient of the patient. Just don't by heart the warmth, the hot and chilly of a remedy.
Right.
It doesn't have any, you know, when you understand the remedy in its whole extent, this should be understood. This chilliness, sepia, chilly. Indifference, isn't it? Ignition, chilly, when it goes into state of, what you have this rubric all about, you always love this rubric to say.
Disconcerted.
Disconcerted rubric, very good. Now can you please elaborate on this disconcerted rubric, Joey, please.
If you split the rubric.
Just a minute.
Yeah.
Listen, this disconcert is very, very important. Okay? Yeah, Joey.
Split the word disconcerted, you have dis and concerted. So there is concert.
See the, how we understand the remedy. The word is disconcerted, but the origin of this word comes from concert. And this is dis hyphen concerted. So we break the remedies, we break the words. We understand the remedy so deeply. We understand the rubric so deeply. It is not just one liner and we just give it a prescription.
Right.
No, it's not like that. We understand the rubric in deep. Continue. Disconcerted.
So there's a concert going on. In all the workings of Ignatia, in her daily day-to-day activities, there's a rhythm, there's a way she works, and it is, you can see that it is going, everything is going harmoniously. Even while she's washing her dishes, she's keeping the dish there. There is a good sound to it, there's a good feel to it. But when she goes into that state of disconcerted, or sara talmel bigad jata hai.
Sara talmel. Ye Mohanty sir ne bahut achi tarah bataya tha. The Mohanty sir showed us this disconcert very beautifully. The talmel means what? The whole show gets devastated. The whole mood of this person goes into the state of devastation. So he has given a very good example of disconcerted. This is the woman washing utensils. Yogesh Rajurkar videos. He had shown this. She's fine dancing with the tunes of the family members. Acha, you want milk? Hey, you want cup of tea? Okay, with sugar? Without sugar? Come. Okay, kaka bye. Acha, you want tiffin? Everything is going in a very smooth way.
Right.
The tuning.
Exactly.
The rhythm. Rhythm is not dakchik dik chik dakchik dik. This is not the rhythm. The rhythm is according to the this
tunes
of the family. According to the needs of the family, she's dancing. Cold water, warm water, this, that. See the dance. This dancing is providing, is
caring.
This is what you mean to say.
Right,
this
right,
is,
exactly.
And what happens when Ignisha gets disc, goes into the state of disc? Now this is the hot, the heat of Ignisha, the hot. One, Ignisha is hot. When in the acute stage, in the initial stage, she tries to make everything possible. She tries to make it everything palatable. She tries to make everything lovable, livable, nice, smooth, in concert.
Right.
Anna?
Exactly.
And then, once she gets that irritation, once she goes into a state of disconcerted, then what happens?
So
see the expression.
The sign.
Put it this word. Very good. Thank you for this.
Bull ke kya fayda.
Now there is nothing left. Ab bull ke kya fayda. There may be so many instances when the patient will be like this. The physician is asking. The physician is very in a very spongy type of guy. Yeah, tell me, how can I help you? And the Ignisha, the chilly Ignisha. He will tell. My husband will tell. This sighing with grief.
Yes.
Sorry. See, we enjoy. We enjoy homeopathy. So guys, see, we are laughing. We are not laughing at the emotions of the patients. There was a time that we may also land into a state of ignition. Nobody, everyone can land into a state of ignition. But the understanding is so easy and palatable, digestible. You can easily take this. I saw the case.
Right.
What is the main motto of this video? Our videos rather. You need to understand. I have seen so many cases in my clinic. I've missed Ignisha somewhere.
Right.
So don't miss. Don't. This is what is the hot patient of Ignisha, the chilly patient. Ignisha chilly like this. Once we start about talking about any remedy, as I always say in every video, see, it's impossible to portray the whole drug picture in one single video. We need to, what you say. If you start talking about Ignisha, it will take many days to get an understanding this remedy. But what we want you all, my dear friends, we want you all to understand what is the exact, that crux of the case, what is that exact pinpoint, that epicenter of Ignisha.
Right.
Yeah, na?
Right.
So we will not discuss every, we'll give, at the end, we'll give some situational materia medicas. What you call a situational matter, what is the feeling when you should think about Ignisha, that I'll let you know later on. But I think we should focus on Ignisha, the two more main remedies, rubrics, and that one, what you feel is the main rubric.
I think sensitive to moral impressions is
great. See, so you tell them so what are those criteria of sensitive to moral impression of Ignisha. So they would, they come to know very easily what is this all about.
Ignisha is the remedy who is very concerned with right and wrong. They cannot imagine themselves doing any wrong.
Sai.
And for them, the things that happen in the family should stay in the family, and going out and speaking it out is also wrong for them.
Yes.
So when you probe about whatever is happening with them or what is making them ill, if you ask her, she just quietly looks down and
again mark the expressions. I'll request Juvin, please repeat this. See, this is really very very important. Okay, and Juvin, you are acting very good. Congrats. Welcome to the acting team of homeopathy and HNF. Focus,
So, when you ask her what is bothering her or what is, what is the problem actually, she'll just look down. And... Okay, sir.
have you noticed this small smile? This smile is really very important. This smile, you know, she's trying to hide all the emotions.
The eyes will well up, but she tries to control it.
No, no. Eyes look down. What is this right and wrong all about? If a physician asks, now I beg every doctor who is watching this video, please try to understand the sensitivity of Ignisha. Don't be that dry like alumina. Bolo kya takleef hai aapko? Aisa mat poocho. Don't ask questions. Be that sensitive. Try to be that sensitive to understand that sensitivity of Ignisha. There should be the synchronization of the physician with the patient. If there is a Varadram in front of you, be like Varadram. Mm-hmm. But when there is Ignisha in front of you, please ask her. Just look into the eyes of Ignisha and ask her, tell me, something is going wrong here. Come on. Something is going wrong. This is the question you have to ask. Haan, bolo, aisa ho hi nahi sakta hai. I have some doctor. Nahi, aisa ho hi nahi sakta. Kuch toh darpar hai. Don't ask these things. Kuch toh hai, yaar. Kuch toh takleef. Then Ignisha will tell you everything.
Exactly.
Isn't it?
Yes, yes.
And this right and wrong, exactly. Ignisha doesn't want to express everything in front of the physician for the first time. This is right. This is not right to tell anything bad about my husband or my mother-in-law.
Exactly.
This is what you wanted to say.
Yes, yes, yes.
No, I won't. Sometimes I ask Joen, you see, your mother-in-law is so... why only mother-in-law? Are your daughter-in-law also. It may be anyways. Why your mother-in-law or why your daughter-in-law is so dominating and you don't say anything to her? No, I don't. Say because she's kya bolte usko, she's very much older than me, so I cannot shout
right
at this age, you know. She's so much older, or she's like mother to me, so I cannot, you know, put my voice up in front of my mother-in-law. That is the thing. So I just bears everything. I just bear everything. How many? I'm just trying to bear everything, isn't it?
Yes.
Anything, any given good morals example you have, any more examples you have regarding morals? Because this morals means right and wrong. So, in morals what happens? There is a right and wrong, means lie. I think she cannot bear false statements. Okay? She cannot bear hypocrisy. She doesn't like, manipulations in the family. Whatever this, you tell me. If you have any affair, tell me. But don't just hide it in front of me. This is Ignisha. The husband, don't dare to do that. Okay. This is Ignisha.
Right.
You are drunk? No. Hmm. Tell your wife that you are drunk, you had consumed alcohol 2-3 pegs down, it's okay. But if you not tell her, then it becomes a problem.
Right.
Anna? There's one more word of Ignisha, is idealistic. Idealistic. We have a rubric. Joen and Rushal, I hope you will put all those rubrics in this video. Because Lakshmi, you also do the same, okay? Because putting down the rubrics with the remedy will be more easy to understand. What I would like to tell my viewers, sensitive to moral imprint, there are so many remedies. There is Dalkamara, Pulsatilla, Lambam Metallicum, Digital. There are many, many remedies. The most common rival of Ignisha is Pulsatilla. Please don't. Get into the trap of Pulsatilla, because Pulsatilla also will be that mild, that yielding, that affectionate, that caring, that careful, that sensitive to moral impression, that selflessness you find Pulsatilla in. But at the same time, Pulsatilla is in the rubric hypocrisy, and Ignisha is pure. And Pulsatilla is hypocrisy. And this is the exact, because when you will ask anything about the family to Pulsatilla's, what Pulsatilla will say? Yes, my husband is start crying and just go on complaining about the husband. Ignisha will mind it, my dear friends. Ignisha will never ever directly start complaining about the husband. Hey, maybe, there may be, if the fish is that sensitive and asking that sensitive way, it's okay. But it is really very difficult. Means it would be, I would say, impossible that the Ignisha patient is directly starting, yes, my husband, he's a big problem in my life. No, no, she will never do that.
Right.
She will, very diligent, a very soshik in Hindi or Marathi, we call it soshik, bearing everything, keeping up everything inside. And they are idealistic, we are a rubric, idealistic. This idealistic is very important. Idealistic is keeping a picture. This is my picture. Into the box picture. Into the box category. No, no, this is not my cup of tea. Means they don't. Yeah, out of the box, they cannot. Just they cannot behave out of the box. Going out after 11 o'clock. I want. No, 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 I don't like to go out of my house after 9 o'clock. Sorry. I won't come. See, Ignisha is that idealistic. No, if at all, it's wrong. It's wrong, boss. It's wrong. Drinking is wrong. This is wrong. This is not done. Copy, I won't copy. I'll fail, but I won't copy. Then you'll say, no, there are so many people, I won't say, it's my, if at all, I don't want to receive this call. And I, yaar, kiska phone hai? Eh, nahi bol, nahi bol. I won't say nahi hai. I will say, I want to receive the call. Ignisha. But there are many remedies like this. There are some rubrics, honest. You know, there are also these types of guys. But Ignisha is also one of them. No, I won't tell, my husband is not here. I won't. This is the idealism of Ignisha. Into the box. Out of the box, kuch nahi karenge. Chalo yaar, bahar, you are now out of station. Now you are in Malaysia, come on, let us have some good time. You can wear those half pants in the beach. No, no, I don't.
Right.
This is not my cup of tea. This is not my cup of tea. So this is idealistic.
So one thing that I found a bit difficult to understand is such a moral lady, sensitive to moral impressions, and she's also in the rubric adulteress. So how can we
this,
explain that?
That is what you wanted to tell, no? This contradictory. No?
Yes. So,
see the contradictory nature. At one hand, adulterous, one hand, sensitive, moral impure. But my dear friends, this adultery of Ignisha is not adultery with losing all control. She feels this adulteration means what? Mixing up of emotions. Mixing up of two thoughts into one, which is not correct. For example, now this is my husband and I love him from my heart, but this bloody husband is not understanding me. He is not reciprocating that love, care, affection, that due care, that acknowledgement that this woman, he is just living for this man. She is breathing for this husband. She is living only for this husband, and this husband is not bloody taking her into at least a small consideration. Yes, you are done, Ethan. Thank you. What is the only expectation from Ignisha is, yeah, at least I am doing so much. I am living for you. I am slogging for you. Everything I am doing it for you. And bloody at least consider, yeah, at least a small acknowledgement of, yes, you have done it. This you can't do it. This is what hurts, because he's my husband. But I cannot tell in front of anyone, because idealistic. I can't tell anything about my husband. Into the box. No, this is not right. Morals. I won't say anything about my husband. Morals. Hiding herself, isn't it? But some person, maybe a physician, maybe a family friend, whoever, who feels that, Arias, you are doing so much for the family. You are doing so much for the family, and the family is not at all that worthy to give such amount of love, affection and care. come on, yaar, you are doing too much. One sentence can easily, you know, just deviate this thought process, and she will feel, yaar, my husband, 16, 15 years of marriage, is not understanding me, and this man, within 15 minutes of time, yaar, he has understood me, what I want from him. Kaash, he would have been my husband. Bas, that far and no further, that will be her feeling. This husband, who I have given my life to, this husband, and this man, yeah, within 15 minutes, you understood what am I doing for the family. And last 15 years, this man is not bothered what I am doing for the whole family. Kaash, this man would be my husband. So now the thought of adultery has appeared. This thought of adultery has already been there. But that far and no further, she will not allow.
Not cross the line.
To cross the line. Yes, he will not allow to cross the line. She has that in limitations. Boundary. It's okay, I could understand what you mean, but that far and no further. Thank you. This is irrigation. This is irrigation. The exact crux is irrigation. Now, Jovin, I would like to, this contradictory nature of irrigation. One hand is contradictory. One hand, we have a rubric, mildness bears all her sufferings without any outrage. Like this. Okay. And in the next, the other side away, on the other side of this point, defiant, destructiveness clothes off, and defiance and mildness. How can you give one good example to this and how it she lands into this? What happens?
Because we are saying she, we can take the example of the typical housewife.
Yes.
Doing everything, dancing to the tunes, as I said earlier. Mildly bearing everything.
Okay.
Chalega. And she has a high threshold, she will take it for a long period of
hoping. We have a rubric, hopeful in Ignatia. Yes.
Hoping that things will become alright, things that she'll get the due acknowledgement. But
yes,
then she becomes disconcerted. Later on she becomes disconcerted. There's no use.
Like this.
Yes.
Okay.
And then after that the stage comes where she becomes defiant. She becomes, no, nothing doing, I won't take it anymore. This won't do. That's it.
Now, I won't do anything for you, just get lost. If the mother-in-law comes in between, hello, I'm talking with my husband, you don't have any...
Keep quiet.
Please, I'm talking with my husband. Now that sensitive morals, sab gaya baad mein. Abhi jhagda karegi to destructiveness clothes off, yane kapda phadne tak karegi.
Yes.
Then, it's okay. And when Ignisha goes into a state of that irritability, then nobody can stop her. We have this is how we understand the contradictory nature, the symptoms,
exactly.
Physical symptoms, with the mental, emotional makeup of Ignisha, with the drug picture evolution, and understanding the crux. So there are so many things in Ignisha, but this is what how we understand remedies in Achitav. Acha, this rubric, jealousy between children, mind you, the rubric is jealousy between children. When the newborn gets all the attention, this is the rubric, okay? And this is a very common rubric in your clinic, mostly in kids. So I would like to focus this rubric with the help of a case, and this case is really very interesting. It's a case of diabetes in a child at age of 16 years, okay? And this will be, I'll be narrating this case in Hindi because there are so many requests in my chat box ke please sir kuch Hindi mein bataiye. So ye case mein khas unke liye kehne ja raha hoon. जो केस मैं अभी बात से बात कर रहा हूँ कि ये देखो, ये जो बंदा था 16 साल का बच्चा, उसको डायबिटीज था और वो 6 साल से 5 साल से इंसुलिन की इंजेक्शंस ले रहा था. और इंसुलिन की इंजेक्शन लेने के बावजूद भी उसकी शुगर डाउन नहीं थी, या तो उसकी शुगर नॉर्मल नहीं थी, उसकी शुगर 200 के ऊपर ही होती थी। ये केस मैंने वीडियो केस मैंने बताया है बहुत सारे सेमिनार्स में, तो ये सचमुच में होम्योपैथी में ऐसा हो सकता है। इसके ये जानने के लिए आपको मैं जानबूझ के ये बता रहा हूँ। अभी वो विदाउट इंसुलिन है, विदाउट मेडिसिन है, एंड इट्स अ वेरी गुड न्यूज़ फॉर एवरी होम्योपैथिक। देयर शुड बी दैट प्राउड फीलिंग कि बच्चे को डॉक्टर ने बोला जिंदगी भर लेना पड़ेगा, सोचो उसकी हालत क्या होती थी। लेकिन अभी वो बिल्कुल इंसुलिन नहीं ले रहा है। वो केस यू थी कि यू दो जुड़वा भाई थे, नंबर वन नंबर टू, नंबर वन को डायबिटीज, नंबर टू को डायबिटीज नहीं। एज अ डॉक्टर जो हम लोग लेते हैं कि इमोशन इज द ओनली कॉज ऑफ ऑल डिसीजेस, तो एक बंदे को हुआ दूसरे को क्यों नहीं, ऐसा कुछ मेरे मन में फीलिंग आया कि नहीं कुछ तो गड़बड़ है, कुछ तो गड़बड़ है यार। एक ही को क्यों आया डायबिटीज, दूसरे को क्यों नहीं आया, आना तो दोनों को आना था, इजंट इट। तो मैंने उस मम्मी को पूछा प्रेगनेंसी में कुछ प्रॉब्लम था, तो उन्होंने बोला प्रेगनेंसी में तो कुछ नहीं था, आई वॉज रियली वेरी हैप्पी, ट्विंस था इतना मालूम था तो मैं खुश थी, दोनों लड़के होते तो भी ठीक, दोनों लड़कियां होती तो भी ठीक, एक लड़का एक लड़की होती तो भी ठीक, कुछ नहीं था। तो ये क्या हो गया, तो उन्होंने बोला कि नहीं एक प्रॉब्लम था, फिफ्थ मंथ में मेरे ससुर एक्सपायर हो गए और मेरी सास अकेली रह गई, वो बहुत डिप्रेशन में थी। तो उस दरमियान दो तीन महीने हम लोग सब उनके घर में, हम लोग मेरे सास के घर पे रहते थे, अदरवाइज बिफोर प्रेगनेंसी हम लोग अलग रहते थे, क्योंकि हमारा घर थोड़ा, हमारे घर अलग था, उनका घर अलग था, तो मैं थोड़ा अलग रहती थी, तो क्योंकि हमारा घर जॉइंट फैमिली था, इतना बड़ा फैमिली एक साथ रहना नामुमकिन था। तो हम लोग, तो जब ससुर जी गए तो मम्मी जी के लिए हम लोग सब उधर शिफ्ट हो गए। सुनो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, हु आर यू, कि ये जो बंदा था, बंदी थी जो मदर इन लॉ थी, तो मदर इन लॉ को थोड़ा सा दिलासा मिला कि सब लोग मेरे साथ है, तो शी वॉज हैप्पी। सो लोग डिलीवरी भी उधर ही हो गई, डिलीवरी में दो बच्चे हो गए, दो बच्चे में से एक नंबर वाला बच्चा और दो नंबर वाला बच्चा, दो नंबर वाला जो बच्चा था उसको मदर इन लॉ ने बोला कि इसे मैं रखती हूँ, मैं संभाल लेती हूँ, वैसा भी मेरे को अभी कुछ है नहीं और मेरा भी बैठे बैठे इसको देख ख्याल है, इसलिए मैं इसके साथ रहूंगा, तू अपने एक नंबर के बेटे को अपने घर पे लेके जा, मैं एक नंबर दो बेटे को मेरे पास रखती हूँ। तो मैं बोला फिर एक नंबर के बेटे को ही क्यों डायबिटीज हुआ, तो मैंने आपने उसको प्यार दिया कि नहीं, तो मैंने तो बहुत दिया, लेकिन डॉक्टर साहब ध्यान में रखो। प्रॉब्लम कैसा होता था, नंबर टू वाला जो बच्चा था जो अपनी मेरी सास के साथ था, उसको सब लोग ज्यादा ध्यान देते थे, क्योंकि सास थी, सास का वो बेटा, तो वो सब फेवरेटिज्म था, उसके प्रति ज्यादा फेवरेटिज्म था, इसको कुछ नहीं, इतना नहीं, क्योंकि इसके पास क्या है, इसके पास सिर्फ उसकी माँ और पापा है, इसके पास उसकी माँ पापा दादी चाचा चाची नाना नानी मामा काकी सब लोग इसके साथ, और इधर कौन है, इधर सिर्फ मम्मी डैडी और पापा। तो ऑब्वियसली जब दोनों का बर्थडे होता था ना, तो बर्थडे काटते समय इसको ढेर सारी गिफ्ट और इसको दो तीन गिफ्ट, ये ना इंसाफी है, इनजस्टिस है ना, ये बच्चे को एक साल से समझते आ गए क्या चल रहा है यार, मैंने क्या बाप किया है, ये सब इसको सब लोग प्यार करें और मैं भी उतना ही पढ़ाई करता हूँ, मैं भी उतना अच्छा रहने की कोशिश करता हूँ, मैं भी उतना डिसिप्लिन्ड हूँ, मैं भी इतना आइडियलिस्टिक हूँ, मैं सब कुछ करने की कोशिश करता हूँ, फिर भी सब लोग उसको ये देते हैं। ये सोच सोच के उस लड़के को बहुत बुरा लगा, और उसको झेलते झेलते, उस स्ट्रेस को झेलते, एक्सेप्ट करते हुए, होल हार्टेडली नहीं, हाफ हार्टेडली, क्यों ऐसा क्यों, फिर भी ठीक है, हंसना, सबके सामने जाना, हंसना हंसना हंसना, हंसते रहता था, अंदर ही अंदर जड़ जलते रहता था कि उसको इतना और मेरे को कुछ भी नहीं, और इसकी वजह से उसको डायबिटीज हो गई। मैं बिल्कुल इसमें एग्जैगरेट नहीं कर रहा हूं, मैंने एक डोज उसको इग्निशिया 30 की दी थी, एक इग्निशिया के 30 के बाद 3 दिन SL देने की कोशिश बोला था, और उसके बाद सिंस दैट डे उसके इंसुलिन मैंने उसी दिन बंद करवाए, एक महीने तक मैंने देखा उसके शुगर लेवल्स डाउन 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 होते जा रहे थे। तो फिर हम लोगों ने, मैंने और आशीष इसने सोचा कि हम लोगों ने छोड़ देंगे, क्योंकि वो ये जो इंसुलिन है हम लोग बंद करेंगे। और 2 साल के बाद मुझे वो बंदा नागपुर में मिला, मैंने केस सबके सामने पेश की है और 2 साल के बाद भी उसकी शुगर नॉर्मल है विदाउट इंसुलिन मिठाई खाने के बाद, और अभी भी वो सही है। मैंने ये क्यों बोला क्योंकि केस ये रूबरिक है ना, न्यू बॉर्न गेट्स ऑल द अटेंशन, जेलसी बिटवीन चिल्ड्रन, ये बहुत काम की चीज़ है। जब बच्चा 4 साल का है, छोटी बच्ची 1 साल की, 3 साल का डिफरेंस, ये 4 साल के बच्चे को डॉक्टर साहब पहले तो अच्छा था अभी क्या हो गया, ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, इसको फोकस करो। अच्छा, और एक है कि ये जो जेलसी बिटवीन चिल्ड्रन है ना, ये जो चिल्ड्रन बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, ये आप एडल्ट में भी लगा सकते हैं कि एक घर में 2 बहुएं थी और जो बड़ी बहू है वो बहुत, वो एक निशा है एकदम, सबको अच्छा तरह से डांसिंग इधर उधर में बोला जैसे डांसिंग कर रही थी ये वो ऐसा, और अचानक दूसरे छोटे देवर की शादी हो जाती है और वो पल्सिटल निकलती है और वो सबसे हाय हाय हु गुली गुली करती रहती है, और फिर जी इग्निशिया है जो इतने साल से वो अकेली थी बहु राज कर रहे थे, और अभी क्या हो गया, ये जो नई दुल्हन आई, ये जो नई दुल्हन आ गई ना, और सब लोगों का एटेंशन उधर गया। अच्छा, मेरे शादी के टाइम जब मैं आई थी तब ये नहीं होता, अभी उसको तो ये हो रहा है। अच्छा, वो जब मेरे टाइम पे, जब मेरा फर्स्ट एनएस था तब ये था, अभी इसके फर्स्ट एनएस में इतनी बड़ी तैयारी। अच्छा, मेरा जब प्रेगनेंसी में ये था तब उसमें, अभी इसको तो प्रेगनेंसी। अच्छा, मैं अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस, दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी कॉमनेस्ट थिंग इन आवर डे टू डे प्रैक्टिस, सो प्लीज डोंट फॉरगेट दिस प्रॉब्लम। जेलसी बिटवीन चिल्ड्रन व्हेन न्यू बॉर्न गेट्स ऑल द अटेंशन, न्यू बॉर्न इज अभी जन्मा हुआ है, अभी जन्म हुआ उसका, ओके। सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो please please comment,
share
subscribe and
click the bell icon,
okay, thank you for this,
join. Thank you sir, thank you for this opportunity.
Are bas kya yaar, and join, it was really nice talking with you, discussing with you.
Yes, it was so much
and
fun.
Yes, it was really real fun. We in HHF, we are a family, and my dear viewers, everyone watching this video, we wish you on behalf of HHF a very happy Diwali, prosperous new year, and many happy moments coming awaiting for all of us, for all of homeopaths coming, because the journey of homeopathy is just like this, and you are be enjoying this every moment of life. Thank you all and love you all.
See you.